Welcome to Politics Watch. This is Serbia. Poland. A beautiful parish with a story we favor part two. And you know when Jamaican people say something favor part two, you know it no look good. Which story am I talking about? A story I've covered many times, but today I'm going to sum it all up. See, I've covered many stories, and to do a Sunday video like this usually involves a lot of research, a lot of intelligence gathering, checking, double checking, cross-referencing, making sure it's everything good. But I can tell you right now, I've never seen anything as complex as this. I've never seen a story with more twists and turns, and even when all is said and done, it seemed like there's still more questions than answers. But by the time this video ends, you're gonna understand what I talk about. The lady, where's it on your screen right now? Marilyn McDonald, aka Petal. She's the first wife of Everton McDonald, aka Beachy Stout. No, you may just have heard recently. Beachy Stout was charged, not just for the second wife, Tanya, right, but also for the first one. Now, the first wife was 12 years ago. Why am I talking about this now? You see, life is funny, you know. Sometimes I do things, for example, something as serious as taking somebody's life. And you think to yourself, well, 5-10 years pass, everything all right. Nobody know, we can move on, and then out of nowhere, you're a part of a video. You're a part of a video like this. It doesn't all make sense. But I could talk about the first wife, because you've been hearing about the second a lot, because that one is the recent one, and the news and, you know, a lot of attention. Social media has been talking about the second wife, Tanya McDonald. But let me give you the build up to it. See, as me say, Marilyn and Beachy Stout, but them did marry first. Marilyn end up losing her life in an incident where she come home as she about to take out her grandson. Man pull up on her and take her life. Right there, so grandson still in the car. Terrible, terrible scenes. Neighbors them said them witness two men are run from the scene. Now recently we have heard that the police them charged Beachy Stout on the basis of a statement they had from Beachy Stout's nephew. Make a look into this nephew. His name was Philbert. Philbert McDonald. Guess who was in the Observer? Guess who had his own local post in the Observer? Way back in the day. 2011. Yes, the same Philbert McDonald. What was he doing in the Observer? Well, he spoke to them, telling them basically about the fact that, you know, because he's a farmer. Part-time farmer and eagle. Look at your screen right now. This is the picture that came in the papers. This was the man that wrote that key statement that make it possible for Beachy Stout get charged for what happened to Marilyn. He was speaking to the police before he lost his life. And he detailed how a policeman by the name of Detective Duncan was responsible for what happened to Marilyn, as in Beachy Stout paid him and him sort it out. And in the video I did recently, you hear me asking what happened to this policeman. Well, he's still alive. He's currently in the United States of America. Detective Duncan, full name Christopher Duncan, left Jamaica shortly after the whole thing go down. Gone a foreign as me say, it's been 12 years now, probably start new life, have much, have all family would even know, say, him cut left Jamaica, and cut left all kind of problem, because before this, we've never heard his name in the mainstream media. People in Portland know about him, and they know about Jamaicans, they never know about him. And they see the whole thing with foreign again. Much man just do the mud with Jamaica, and then Scott got a friend, and JCF just left them. But don't worry, it get worse than that. We're going to talk about JCF. Yeah, well, in particular, Portland Police. We could go back to Philbert McDonough. Now, after knowing what went down with Merlin, he went to the police and started to give them information. To the point where he even wrote a statement. Let me say that statement make it possible for Beaches to get charged now. But then in September 2012, guess what happened to Philbert McDonough? You guessed it right. Him losing life. But here the story now. The official story is that some man try rob him woman, right? His common law wife. As she come home about 8:30 at the night, man pounce on her and demand money. She call him out of the house as them a drew car down. When him run come out of the house, the man them wet him up and take off. Nothing never happened to her. I have to be honest. When we first read this story, because the mainstream version in Observer, right, it just said that, you know, his common law wife returned home, and then, you know, then demand money, and the woman reportedly ran and shout, and then Philbert wrestled with the man them, and then that's the official story of the papers, but people on the ground dispute the more clean cut version we have seen in the papers. For them eyebrows raised when it went down, and my own raised when me and A were gone. Because Portland people they must say look like it's a smoke screen. Remember me telling Mr. Philbert did write a statement to the police. We're not gonna understand why the people in Portland don't believe the whole smokescreen story about how he lost his life, because see Philbert did start to talk, not just to the police but in general. It was really starting to affect him what happened to Merlin. Right. And as he was telling them people, I talk to the money. Word got back to Beaches out. Say Philbert, his nephew, attack. And I tell people what went down. Now, how many people believe, say? Right after Philbert give police statement and start talking and tell people, say, Beaches get out, Merlin. Him just happened to lose his life in such a spooky nighttime operation. See, here's the real question for me. Because if I was a betting man, it would be an easy bet. But here's the real question for me. Was it the police them go tell about Beachy? Or was it somebody who Philbert tell go tell about Beachy? Or somebody carried the news back to him? Remember, Beachy was so close to the police them that he went to a policeman to set it up. Right, so the policeman was the person who got get the 87s then. Because remember the witnesses, them tell them to two man I run, two 87s, right? Now we have a better understanding of how it went down, right? He paid the policeman, and the policeman go for the 87s then, and 87s then carry it out. So clearly Beachy had enough influence and enough links inside of the police, down in Portland, to find out who had his statement upon him. So it wouldn't be hard for him to say, Philbert McDonald, I write statement and I give police info. Now here's the next thing. Philbert McDonald lose him life in September 2012, and he gave the police a statement because the last time he checked, nobody can steal a dove cart or made a arrest and write no statement. So that means that the statement was written, and any testimony, any evidence them give the police was given to them before September 2012. So ask yourself this question: how beach is out only I get charged for it in a 2021? Almost 10 years later. Talk to me, people. You know, see the problem, listen. You know, see the problem? Let me tell you what the problem. This whole thing reeks of corruption. Reeks. The Portland police, especially the one them with the Daron at the time, it's not a good look. It's not a good look because everybody I talk to, I say the same thing. Everybody, I say, each is thought had far too much influence upon the police then. Incident took place in 2009. Philbert losing life in 2012. And in 2021, after the second wife and after the whole paper uproar and after the spotlight and after next to the police take it over. At them time there, Beachy thought I get charged. Something is wrong here. Something is wrong here. The whole thing smell like a sewage dump. It don't smell good. So the same way the police them look back upon the Marilyn McDonald case, Petal's case, the first wife, at the same way them need to go look back upon Philbert's case. If you bring in back some more people, ask some more questions, got too much coincidence, I go on this one. Now, one thing you have to understand is that Beachy Stout is not a new suspect when it comes on to what happened to Petal, you know, the first wife. Everybody there already pointed the finger upon Beachy Stout. People didn't even tell the police, them say, look upon Beachy Stout first, because him not tell people, say. Right? And you have to understand from what I'm gathering, he's a very brash man, right? Walk on making big talk to him all the time. Right? He was telling people, say, listen, him, you know, say, Petal, David, quote unquote, soldier boy, right? And oh, she take him money and go do tummy talk, right? And before he make she take him money and leave him, right? Him rather do this and him rather do that. And him not take this and him not take that. And if she feel like pay a big talk, him let me. And not privately. From me understand, bitches, any look at ends him there, man. Him now whisper and talk so everybody can know, because the man felt invincible in Portland. Him feel like, say, nobody couldn't touch him. And you can understand why, him they have police in their pocket. To the point him a link police to sort out him owner Upstein. Extraordinary. Now, but you want to know one thing. Since that happened to Petal, nobody never tell Tanya, say, be careful, a beach is down. Guess what? Tanya and beach is down, did they? Before even the first wife lose her life. A matter of fact, Tanya and Petal had a fight shortly before Petal lose her life as the first wife, Marlene. When you hear me say a while ago, the second wife and the first wife, them fight. And make it fairness and it's not one or two times. That was one of the biggest issues the two of them had. As in, beaches out and better. Now, you know this channel is not about man and woman affair, but don't worry, you're gonna understand why I bring this up. The fact that second wife and first wife used to fight before even first wife lose her life, and then after first wife lose her life, the what Jamaican call matey end up become the wife. Who to tell if she even knew what happened? I know say a bitch is told get rid of the first wife. No, I can't say for certain, but if I was a betting man, I would say she probably knew say a bitch is told get out better. Because everybody, even people outside of the relationship, is already pointing the finger up on Beachy's throat, because Mr. Indy said in big talk them and make him treat them all the time. And she never know nothing. See, enough time woman there with a man, and see where a man do a next woman, and things say, them special, and the same thing can happen to them. Oh, well, you know, in that is she, but me different. Sometimes women they end up finding out the hard way. What go deeper in there now? Beatrice Stout and Tanya, the second wife I talk from Shagar School. I'm Shagar School, mean girl school, school uniform. From them time the Marlene, the first wife. Be a problem. Beachy Stout was very brazen. Kara go up on him, look at him with him in our school uniform. Other people didn't see and not say nothing, because again, Beachy Stout have your money. And when you have your money in a certain place, in Jamaica, nobody didn't see nothing. Nobody didn't see this big man walk in a place with school girl in a uniform. Not only that, I go show no Beachy Stout brazen. Beachy Stout was also blamed for what happened to Tanya's father and mother before she ended up losing her life. You see, Beachy Stout was a man where he used to throw on like perfume woman in anywhere he feel like. Right? In front of him staff and in front of people, it no matter. He felt invincible. And after one of these publicly embarrassing moments, Tanya tell her father, and her father called Beachy Stout. He Beachy Stout a peace of mind, make him know, say, don't make it happen again. I guess Beachy Stout took it personal. Next thing people know, Tanya's mother and father were attacked by 87s. The father didn't survive, right? But the mother did, thankfully. But because it happened right after the incident with Tanya, and then the father called Beachy Stout, and then that got him to the father and the mother. Once again, people were looking at Beachy Stout. Remember, this is Portland. And in Portland is a place that have like 9-10 murders for the year. So when these things are happening, because the place is so small and no only for shooting they really go on, when them things are happening, it kind of easy for people to narrow it down, especially when they can trace the history of the conflicts. Anyway, once again, Beachy Stout was never brought for justice. He never even get charged. See, this is why I get a better picture as to how come people like one so when the first charge dropped. Even before the charges dropped, when Tanya lose her life and the name Beachy Stout first pop up on the radar, I was thinking to myself, why Portland people are telling Mr. Beachy Stout can't get charged? I was confused. I was thinking to myself, then, because to be honest, I didn't know of Beachy Stout before all of this. So I said, why people from Portland are making it sound like say Beachy Stout can't, like Beachy Stout above the law? No, me understand. Because so much thing happened down there. Right. And him always a bust case to the point that him not even go in front of one judge one day. There was an incident where him accused him second of thieving money from him, and the youth literally lose him finger. Even since he's been behind bars now, three of them workers them lose them life in some very spooky circumstances. Right. The name Beatty Stout is just surrounded by all kind of crosses. Inna start with the first wife, inna done with the second. But this is what Beatty Stout never realized. Most of his power and influence was concentrated inside of Portland. In Portland, he was the big man. In Portland, he was the top dog. In Portland, he could just use the money, right, buy out. If you understand, some police were actually trying to investigate him, but none of them didn't pack it. Because somehow, he always seemed to get some information where people did tell police directly, and somehow he ended back in a Beatty Stout ears. Even the same detective, Duncan, Iman Beachy, were suspected right from the beginning, because as I said, people are calling the police and I tell the police, Beatty Stout did send him check, Beatty Stout did say I'm going to do this, Duncan, Philbert, them attack, all kind of people attack. And them still make Duncan left the island. They still make Christopher Duncan, even after him died, friend, even after them have the statement. If you can charge Beatty Stout based on Philbert's statement, and Philbert identified Detective Duncan, you go ask the same question they asked in the Brady video. Why them can't send an extradition request? Carry him back at Jamaica. It no matter if a 5, 10, 15 years ago. How hard is it you send to Uncle Sam? Here we have a statement. This man needs to come face trial upon Jamaican soil. Come on, JCF, it can't be that hard. It cannot be that hard. Other country do it every minute we see them as send this money. Patreon squad, PIA, what was over here? Is either you can't do it or you don't want to do it. The man name in the statement. The statement to them sit down pan. For over a decade. Why are only now Beatty Stout to get charged? After all, there's a trail of death and destruction surrounding this man name. Taxi man get fined over here, so. Right. Friend get fined over here, so. People who said this happened to them. Come on, Portland. Portland CIB, come on, I'm better than this. I'm better than this. Beautiful, beautiful Portland. Don't tell me that I saw now, God. I understand, so the police them were at work now might not even be the same police them were at work then. But even so. Question still have to answer. Because we understand, say, Beatty Stout money never underweight it, never miss a meal. Beatty Stout money heavy. And it went very far in Portland. Anybody come across him, anybody step in him way, anybody talk against him, strange things happen to them. And he never got caught. Because of the investigation for all the previous cases him attached to him. He got caught because he went a bridge too far. The Tanya McDonald case, because him do that in the era when you know we have social media and everything upon the news and people ask questions, so it hard to lay low. You see, 10, 12 years ago, you see the first wife, them time there, maybe those people in Portland know about it, you know, so. You know, it's not national news, so people not ask no question. That's one of the good sides of social media. Social media have its flaws, but that's one of the major benefits of social media. Social media plays a major role in a crime fighting. Back in the day when they only have the two big TV stations, the money really for listen news, man, enough things used to fly past people because news just speak out the two or three biggest stories. And for them thinking they might get a look at one post, one observer, but now something happened. It make every IG page, every YouTube channel can't hide again. So even people like Beachy Stout, who used to just do them thing, pay a little money, get rid of people, and then not come out of it, nobody not talk about it. Them days are done. Them days are done. So that's one of the good sides to social media. How many more unsolved cases out there attached to Beachy Stout? Better yet, how many other Beachy Stouts are out there? That me wanna know. Disappointing play case as Mr. Portland. Beautiful part, definitely top two favorite places in Jamaica for Portland. I love Portland. But foolishness is a foolishness. And based on how me and enough people are Portland that treat Beachy Stout even after them know what them do. The same people them who talk and say Beachy Stout do this and Beachy Stout do that. When them come around and I buy them this and I buy them that cause them used to use them money, you know? Walk go in a bar, free liquor for everybody, buy drink what you want. And put on a stage show, free entrance, everybody can go and go party. Them thing they make people turn a blind eye to anything what you do. Beachy Stout understood the people, them understand, say, listen, if we just give them this and give them that and put on this and put on that, you know, that's why always they talk about the treat, cherry chicks. Enough people turn a blind eye, calling the big man, calling the general, even though them know. Well, one, because them same one that talk about the story and the incidents. It's a shame. A real shame. Jamaica have a major problem with unsolved cases, cold cases. When you start out this extradition thing, people like Christopher Duncan, people like Birdie, let me forget bring back to Jamaica, face the courts out there. Police can know, say, are you responsible for this and know, say, you ain't even attached on this. And you just sit on a foreign, and just because they cross the water, something can't harm to you. That's not how foreign governments deal with them criminals. Foreign governments send for them criminals, so why we can't send for our warning? Too much unsolved cases, I'm not forgot enough of them. We not forgot about the case, but Trail Heights, 81 year old. Could pick them, we not forget about it. Naturally, I work on the case still. See, I forget my case, you know. So, I don't want nobody to ask me what if I update on the case. When the case is updated, you will know, because you see the video drop. I work on that one, then. Can't make that go so. I already make some leeway. Right. Actually, a woman hired a hitman, then, to go for the youth. The old lady that lose her life. The youth didn't go for related to her. Even them didn't really want about him, nobody did. On the swarm to granny and the two people then. But it was a woman send the youth them on the hit. As for the youth them who go on the hit. Don't worry man, I work on it. See enough people believe social media when the video go around claim say the two men where them find at them. Right, that them did go up on Trail Heights apps and then did take all the pit in them, so that's why them only can't believe who she said for now, but me I work on the case. But even time I do the video, me tell one of the bed bugs them say, I know what you did last summer. Just go and relax man. Now for these cold cases, they're gonna get hot again. Also, we can't forget about what happened. Thompson Penn. The chef, Janice. Corey Goat Boss thing. Nobody thinks so, forget about it, man. Come on. We don't forget nothing. We know so Jamaica have a 3-day culture now. It used to be 9-day culture, but now a 3-day culture. But certain stories, we just can't forget. Just like how, from the first time we hear about what happened to Charmaine Rattray and her daughter, Jarrett Lynch. From then, even before I made up on YouTube, make up mind say, I will never rest. until we get to the bottom of that story. So we'll finally crack it. Same thing with Tredegar Park. Well, trust me. Same thing with Cheryl Heights. Enough of these cases. The reason why enough of these people who carry out these acts continue to do it is because them can do it in the dark and nobody will shine a light on them. Well, I may not be able to catch everybody, but if I even one or two, if it's even one or two, anyway, people are sick for today. The beach is the whole thing. Enough of the thing them can even talk on YouTube. Because for one, enough of them are man and woman are fear, and I don't even really want to go into that. And certain little details, you know, I don't want to put them things out there, because then it never make the channel kind of sound like, you know, not the kind of things where, not the kind of platform that I'm about. But just know that this thing is so complex, this thing is so twisted. When you talk about man and woman and mix up and all kind of carelessness, it's a real shame. It's a real shame, but beach is not witness. The world of them was in a jail. I'm glad all them are playing them role to keep him alive. But I'm begging you, please, don't slip up, because beach is out. Still have the money out there. Still have the money upon him head. Because if that man no make it, he might walk. Because the Filbert statement, I don't know if the statement alone might be enough. We sink him on the first case. Because obviously Filbert is gone. Here's how J-Safe could make things better for themselves. Send for Christopher Duncan and then make him sink Beach Stout. Make him know how much years he might look upon and then make him sink Beach Stout. Unlikely to happen because they don't know. As the J-Safe spokesman say, we have to be realistic, you know, it's not the movies. I guess sending an extradition request is movies, so let's not get our hopes up, but this whole thing is complex. Anyway, that's it for today. Patreon squad, big up on yourself. You can head over to Patreon in about 15-30 minutes, right? Where there will be a second video, the one that I promised you. There will be a second video waiting for you over there right now, this Sunday, so you can enjoy two videos. Yeah, I don't know. More life. Ultra squad. Go on circle. Go on do your thing. Let me say all the time, even vultures have to eat. Anyway, peace.